हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ गणेश बियागलावे, वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर. इन दिस सेशन ऑफ कंडक्शन वील सी कंपोजिट केसेस, कंपोजिट वॉल, कंपोजिट सिलेंडर एंड कंपोजिट स्पीयर. एट द एंड द स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू ड्रॉ थर्मल नेटवर्क ऑफ द कंपोजिट केसेस, दैट इज कंपोजिट वॉल, composite cylinder and composite sphere. First case is of composite wall. First case is of composite wall. If there are more than one wall is present, it is called composite wall. So suppose this is the wall of material A and second wall is of material B. The surface temperature of wall on this side is T1. The interface temperature is T2 and outermost temperature is T3. Then their thermal network I will be drawing here. Now temperatures of wall A, left hand side temperature is T1, interface temperature is T2, then there will be conductive resistance, R1. The wall A has L thickness, wall B has also L thickness, and the area normal to the heat flow is same in both the cases. So conductive heat transfer is Q. Composite wall is in series. Now the conductive heat Q will be transferring from wall A and B in equal amount, means QA will be equal to QB is equal to Q. Same rate of heat transfer is there through the both walls in series network. Wall B will oppose the thermal resistance and it works between temperatures T2 and T3, and resistance offered will be R2. Here the first resistance, which you can calculate separately, that is R1, is equal to L by KA. KA is the thermal conductivity of A material and KB is the thermal conductivity of B material. Similarly, for second wall, thermal network will be equal to L divided by KB into A. Here the thicknesses may be different, that is L1 and L2. Whenever these are not same, I can substitute here their own notations. Now in addition, with conductive heat transfer, I can add the convective heat transfer. So this will become combined mode of heat transfer. Suppose the internal wall will be heated by means of the gases whose temperature is Ti, and convective heat transfer coefficient is Hi. On the outermost side also there will be fluid properties are there. Suppose second fluid is passing through over this wall having the temperature To and convective heat transfer coefficient is HO. Then I have to add two more resistances. First resistance will be convective resistance. It will be working in between temperature difference Ti and T1, and on outermost side there will be one more convective resistance. This is RC2 and suppose this is RC1. Now RC1 will be equal to 1 by HiA, and RC2 is equal to 1 by HOA. So rate of heat transfer equation can be written as Q is equal to, if I take the temperature Ti and To in consideration, then I have to write in the numerator Ti minus To divided by 4 resistances, that is summation of resistances, which will be equal to Ti minus To divided by this RC1 plus R1 plus R2 plus RC2. Either you can find out the resistance R1, R2, RC1 and RC2 separately, or can substitute their relations in this equation also. So this will become equal to Ti minus To divided by 1 by Hi into A plus L1 by Ka A plus L2 Kb into A plus 1 by Ho A. Now, as area is same, I can take it common also, and the equation can be written as Q by A. Q by A is nothing but heat flux, which can be represented by small q. So small q is equal to QA is equal to Ti minus To divided by 1 by Hi plus L1 by Ka plus L2 by Kb plus 1 by Ho. There is one more concept called overall heat transfer coefficient. So the overall heat transfer coefficient Q is equal to UA delta T. This overall heat transfer coefficient considers mixed mode of heat transfer. So whenever such cases are there, so UA could be written as 1 by thermal resistance, because this equation, Fourier's law of heat transfer, in terms of Fourier's law of heat transfer, can be written as, that is delta T divided by R thermal. As there are two areas are available, so overall heat transfer coefficient will be of two bases. So first one is on inner side, and second one, overall heat transfer coefficient on other side. And one more concept is present, that is called thermal contact resistance. Now second case we will see of composite cylinder. Suppose this is the pipe having R1 and R2 radius, which is insulated with R3. Then their temperatures are suppose T1, T2 and T3. Then thermal network for the composite cylinder between temperature T1 and T2 will be first resistance. Between T2 and T3, there will be second resistance. This is for composite cylinder, where this is the A material and this is the B material. So you can write the conductive heat transfer rate, which is equal to Ti minus T3 divided by R1 plus R2. Similarly, for sphere, you could write also, this is suppose hollow sphere, which is insulated. The inner radius is R1, the outer radius of the sphere is R2, and insulation radius is R3. Then the thermal network will be, this is temperature T1, temperature T2, temperature T3. So this is the temperature T1, temperature T2, temperature T3. This is for sphere, hollow sphere, composite case. resistance, first resistance will be R1, second resistance will be R2. I can add two more resistances of the convective case. So this is suppose Ti, this is the convective resistance first, this is the convective resistance second. I can add for composite cylinder also Ti, this is the RC1, convective resistances RC1 and RC2 will be convective resistances. So in the composite cases, depending upon the number of walls, number of layers of insulations, you can just go on adding the resistances, you will be getting the rate of heat transfer. Similarly, here I can write Q is equal to Ti minus To divided by RC1 plus R1 plus R2 plus RC2. You can calculate rate of heat conduction through the sphere with multiple layers and rate of heat transfer through hollow cylinder with multiple layers of the insulation. These are the different cases. For further study, you can refer Fundamentals of Heat and Mass Transfer by Inkpropera David. Thank you.